everyone, and welcome to a look back at nickel plate road excursion engines. This video was suggested by several of you guys quite a while ago, so apologies for taking so long in getting to that, and apologies for such the long wait between videos. Once again, as a reminder, I'd like to ask that you please hold off on any suggestions for future videos in this series, as I still have one more video to get to before I'm ready to take your guys' suggestions again. With the intro out of the way, let's get started. We start off with 284 Berkshire number 759. Number 759 was built by the Lima Locomotive Works in 1944 for use on fast freight service between Chicago, Illinois and Buffalo, New York. The locomotive would serve the nickel plate for 14 years before being retired in 1958 after receiving a Class 3 overhaul at the railroad's Conneaut Shops in Conneaut, Ohio. After its retirement, the locomotive would remain in storage until 1962 after being bought by F. Nelson Blunt for his Steamtown USA collection and moved to North Walpole, New Hampshire. In 1967, the locomotive was leased by Ross Rowland and the High Iron Company for use on the Golden Spike Centennial Limited, a train meant to commemorate the 100th anniversary of the driving of the Golden Spike. The locomotive was moved back to Conneaut, and following a brief restoration, the locomotive pulled its first excursion in the summer of 1968. As part of her use on the Golden Spike Limited, in 1969 the locomotive was painted into a special blue and gold paint scheme and toured all around the country, even going as far west as Omaha, Nebraska. With the Golden Spike Limited being such a huge success, the locomotive was brought back east where Steamtown continued to use it in excursion service. One of the more notable trips from during this time occurred on May 1st, 1970. The newly created Amtrak was set to take over the nation's passenger rail service on this day. Unfortunately, this meant that they would cut all of the Norfolk and Western's former passenger trains. Not wanting to go out quietly, the Norfolk and Western wanted to have one last special trip. So, the 759 was painted in NMW colors and used to pull the last running of the Pocahontas. With these trips also being a success, the 759 went on to pull even more excursions throughout the eastern seaboard into the early 70s. Unfortunately, 759's excursion career would come to an abrupt end in 1973. After running several trips on the Boston and Maine and Central Vermont Railroad, the 759 was to be stored at the Delaware and Hudson's Roundhouse in Rouses Point, New York. While the D&H crews were in the process of preparing the locomotive for winter storage, they neglected to drain the boiler properly, leaving some water in the flues, which eventually froze over during the winter, causing the flues to crack. Shortly following this, Steamtown sued the D&H for damages and ended up winning. Several repairs were made to 759 over the years to try to get it operational again, but after a flue failed during a hydrostatic test in 1977, it was decided that 759 would remain a static display at Steamtown. In the 1980s, she moved with the rest of the collection from Bellows Falls to Scranton, Pennsylvania, where she remains on display today. Next up is locomotive number 587. This locomotive is a 282 Mikado designed by the USRA, built by Baldwin in 1918, and delivered as number 5541 to the Lake Erie and Western Railroad. The locomotive would serve the Lake Erie and Western until 1922, when the line was bought by the Nickel Plate Road. In 1924, the locomotive will be renumbered to 587. In revenue service, the 587 will be primarily used on freight between Indianapolis and Michigan City, Indiana. After 37 years of service on the nickel plate, the 587 was retired in 1955. Between 1955 and 1983, the 587 will be placed on display in Broad Ripple Park in Indianapolis. That year, the city of Indianapolis was looking to build a new public library in Broad Ripple Park. However, the only space available was where 587 was displayed. Not wanting to lose the 587, a group of volunteers known as the Friends of the 587 conducted an inspection on the locomotive and discovered that it was in quite good mechanical condition. After these findings, the city of Indianapolis leased the 587 to the Indiana Transportation Museum for restoration. Following this, the 587 was moved from its display site to a spot in Amtrak's Beech Grove Shops, where the Indiana Transportation Museum would conduct the restoration. After several years of hard work, the 587 returned to operation in September of 1988. In excursion service, the 587 mainly saw use on the museum's fair train, hauling passengers to and from the Indiana State Fair between Indianapolis and Fishers, Indiana. In addition to pulling the fair train, the 587 would be involved in a number of NRHS conventions throughout the late 80s, 1990s, and early 2000s. Because of this, the 587 was used on many doubleheader and even tripleheader excursions with Norfolk and Western 1218 and 611 in 1989, and even a doubleheader trip in 1993 with Nickel Plate Road number 765, which we'll cover later in this video. In 2003, the 587 will be pulled from service for her FRA-mandated 15-year rebuild. and it's here where 587's story would take a sour turn. As a result of very little funding, the restoration process was very slow, and continued for the better part of 15 years. Things would get even worse around 2017 as the ITM found itself in legal trouble. Without going into too much detail, the ITM eventually ended up being evicted from their current location and put the 587 in jeopardy of being scrapped if they weren't fast enough to move it. Luckily, the 587 found some allies in the Kentucky Steam Heritage Corporation who were gladly able to take in 587 until they could find a new home for her. And with that, the 587 was completely disassembled and moved to Kishco's home base in Ravenna, Kentucky, where the locomotive currently resides today. And now we end this video off with by far the most popular of the Nickel Plate Road Excursion stars, number 765. A sister to the aforementioned 759, 765 is a 284 Berkshire built by the Lima Locomotive Works in 1944. In revenue service, the 765 was first assigned to fast freights out of Bellevue, Ohio, but was later reassigned to Fort Wayne, where it would spend the rest of its career. Its final revenue assignment would happen in December of 1958, where the locomotive would be assigned to supply steam heat to a stranded passenger train. This would mark the last time a steam locomotive operated on the Nickel Plate under their own power. Following this, the 765 would be stored serviceable indoors in Fort Wayne. In 1963, the city of Fort Wayne requested that Sister Berkshire No. 767 be placed on display in Lawton Park as a means to commemorate the Elevate the Nickel Plate project that took place several years prior. Instead, the Nickel Plate decided to renumber 765 into 767 and donate that locomotive, as the real 767 was in poor cosmetic and mechanical condition. In the early 1970s, a group of rail fans began discussing the feasibility of restoring the Nickel Plate Berkshire. This group would later go on to become the Fort Wayne Railroad Historical Society. After enough funds were gathered, the group managed to move the 765 in 1974 from its home in Lawton Park to the restoration site in New Haven, Indiana. Starting in 1975, the locomotive would undergo an extensive restoration process, being conducted entirely outdoors. These efforts would eventually pay off in September of 1979, when the 765 steamed again for the first time in decades. After being moved to Bellevue, Ohio for winter storage, the locomotive would embark on a series of test runs in 1980 on the Toledo, Peoria, and Western Railroad. The 765's first big outing would come in 1982, when the Southern Railway leased it for 22 trips as part of their steam excursion program, as a means to replace fellow Berkshire Chesapeake and Ohio No. 2716, which had succumbed to firebox problems. The 765 would go on to operate on many other rail excursions throughout the late 80s and early 90s on Norfolk Southern, New Jersey Transit, and CSX tracks. One of the most famous of these trips was the New River Train, an annual fall foliage excursion which occurred on the CSX New River subdivision between Huntington and Hinton, West Virginia. These trips became so popular that the length of the train would often exceed over 30 passenger cars. In addition to the New River Train, the 765 would be used in a number of NRHS excursions, including trips with 1225 through the New River Gorge in 1991, and a doubleheader excursion with the aforementioned 587 between Fort Wayne and Chicago, Illinois. Following the 1993 operating season, the 765 would go down for what was originally slated to be running gear work. This work would quickly expand into a full-blown rebuild, causing the locomotive to not be seen again under steam until 2006. After returning to steam that year, the locomotive would pick up right back where it left off, being used on mainline excursions and appearing at several special events over the years. Between 2011 and 2015, the 765 would tour all across Norfolk Southern's system as part of their 21st Century Steam program. As of today, the 765 continues to see use on special tourist line events and special mainline excursions across the Midwestern United States. And that's going to do it for a look back at Nickel Plate Road Excursion Engines. As I said in the beginning of the video, please hold off on any suggestions you may have for future videos, as I still have one more video in this series to get to. If you have any constructive criticisms, or if I missed any locomotives, please let me know in the comment section below. And once again, I'd like to thank you all for your continued support of this series. That's going to do it for this video. Thanks for watching.